takininidabamagarigari takajam takadam takarum takaninidabamagarigari imabadani
tam tadiginato
imamabar imabadani mabadani
satam tatam tadiginato tadiginato
imabamabadapadani imabadani mabadani sabadani sadi
Hello everyone. Looks like the lockdown has created many more avatars of ourselves, and for me, it's one as a cook. I know we're always talking about health and how dancers should eat healthy, and I agree with that, but I also think that one should not compromise on taste. Because after all, it's not just the ingredients that you're putting into yourself, but if you don't enjoy the finer aspects of what you're eating, savor each taste, then it's not going to do much for your digestion. At least that's my theory. So today I'm going to show you a very simple recipe and I think mostly healthy, peanut butter corn masala. This is something like a hand-me-down from my mother. I would love to say that this goes back hundreds of years to my great-grandmother's kitchen, but I don't see her dabbling with pintola peanut butter and boiled corn. So let's just say the antiquity of this dish is going to be 20 years. I'll get my videographer to now show you the very simple ingredients that you need for this dish. I have boiled corn and cut it into bits. We have a mixture of kottamalli and pudina here, a handful, a little kottamalli for garnishing later, some garlic or poonda. I got 3 pods cut here, and lime, green chili. I took one long one, but it depends on whether you like it very spicy. We also have manjapodi, turmeric, salt and oil. If you can use olive oil, that'll be really nice. It gives a really nice taste. So the first thing we do is we take this bunch of kottamalli, pudina, and we dump it into the mixie. We have the green chili and the chopped garlic. We can add a dash of water, no harm, not too much. Just so that it doesn't stick to the sides. Okay, now let's hope that the lid doesn't go flying off. In case it does, we will just edit it. Okay, so the kottamalli and the coriander are ground pretty fine now. I leave it here. I just turned on the fire and we can add a generous dollop of olive oil so that you at least feel very healthy. Right. Now I'm going to add in the greens here. I'm using a very big kadai here so that it doesn't sputter all over the place and make a mess. Don't throw away the rest of it because we can add some water and finish off the last bits of masala when we need to. Point, you have to be a little patient because you have to mix it on low fire
for say about 5 minutes for sure until the color changes, otherwise it's going to taste very raw. So as you can see, now it's been about 2 minutes, but don't go by the time, like I said, the smell, that raw smell has gone, and also the color has slightly changed here, as you can see. Alright, so you can now zoom out. And the interesting thing about this mixture is that I've done a basic preparation, but if you like it slightly Indian style, then you can add jeera, coriander powder, chili powder. Okay, but I like it very simple like this. Now at this point, since it's been cooked, I've heard that if you add lime really early on, it becomes bitter. So I'm going to add the lime now, and this is an important ingredient because it gives it a real zing. Okay, so about maybe 2 teaspoons there. I've mixed it. Hopefully you have very sweet corn, because this combination of the sweet corn and the salty peanut butter is really nice. Alright. Now we will add my favorite ingredient, the peanut butter. Those who know me know how obsessed I am about peanut butter. This dabba usually lasts me about 2 weeks, not more. The crunchy variety is better, and to make it healthy, it says 100% natural, unsweetened. Pintola, please sponsor this video. I'm going to start with 2 tablespoons. Like I said, there's no fixed measurement. I'm going to mix it in. Can we zoom in here? And mix it around. Maybe a dash more. So you got a nice creamy texture here, but you also have the crunch of the peanut butter. Can you show us in here? That's right. Good. Now it wouldn't hurt to taste. Not bad. Wash your hands, of course. I think we can add a dash of lime. Yes. And then we can add another 1/2 cup of water. Add it in slowly and mix it. Don't just dump it in. Salt is also fine. So you should get kind of a curry, thick curry consistency, because you see that next we are going to put the corn in. We let this simmer for about 1 minute. And then I'm going to add my corn. So I did add another extra spoon of peanut butter because I felt that the greens were too strong. I'm also going to add a dash more of lime. So you can assume that you can use a full 1/2 and then maybe 2 squeezes of the second 1/2. Okay, so this is the consistency, as you can see. Thick, and you can see that the oil is starting to separate. Right, now we come to the final stage, which is corn. Okay, and getting sweet corn is very important because otherwise it will taste very insipid. You probably can do the same thing with udri corn, whatever you call that. I think that biting into it with the masala definitely tastes better. Alright, 5 may be enough for this quantity of masala, so let me see once I spread it, and if I feel there's enough masala, I'll add in the rest. So you coat the corn in this masala. I think we can put in one more. Yes, that's right. Coat it nicely. Okay, so after about 3 minutes of tossing it in, you see that the oil has separated, it's kind of the masala has soaked into the corn, and it's done. Remember that this process of rasa or experience is not complete unless somebody tastes it. So I'm going to have my right hand man here, Shri Krishna, to try it. Okay, so here is Krishna looking very enthusiastic, going to try my corn masala. Tell me how it is. Hey.
Wow, you really want to know how it is?
Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum.
Yeah, babe, yeah, babe. In the morning or late.
Hello,
everyone.
It
looks like the lockdown has
Hey, everyone.
It looks like the lockdown has... Wait, 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 wait. Let me get my first sentence correct. 50-50 love the way you split it.